The God News YouTube channel is what you're watching. Welcome aboard, guys. Got some new news for you concerning Edgar Berlanga, the guy that will be up against Saul Canelo Alvarez. Now, Edgar Berlanga says to beat Canelo Alvarez, he will need his jab, and that jab will be his breadwinner on the night. Edgar Berlanga first made up his name by showcasing his power, knocking out his first 16 opponents after turning pro. But for Berlanga to have a chance of beating Canelo Alvarez in less than 2 weeks, his jab will be pivotal. This is going to be our breadwinner, the jab right here, Berlanga said in a recent interview with Michael McCarthy, also known as Large of Buzz Tool Sports. To land a big punch, you got to set it up. Guys like him at that level, you can't go out there and just try to throw bombs. He's going to see it, he's going to execute on that. So it's about setting up, being smart in that ring, and having a good discipline. Berlanga, 22 fights, no losses, 17 knockouts, complimented Canelo as having a crazy IQ and a great defense. At the same time, Berlanga knows that power punches will still matter. He goes off respect to Berlanga, said, if I am over here pity panting him, he's going to walk right through. I'm coming to fight, man. This is balls to the walls for me. This is the opportunity of a lifetime that I have to grasp towards. This is, of course, the biggest opportunity yet and the toughest test for Berlanga. After his knockout streak, Berlanga had five straight decision wins as he stepped up against and was tested by better opponents. Demond Nicholson, Marcelo Contreras, Steve Rolls, Roma Alexi Anguro, and Jason Quigley. In Berlanga's last performance, he knocked Pedreg McCrory out in six rounds. Now he's about to fight in a pay-per-view main event. Canelo versus Berlanga is scheduled for Saturday, September 14th at T-Mobile Arena in Las Vegas. The show will be available via Amazon's Prime Video, the Zan pay-per-view.com, and traditional cable and satellite outlets. This is the kind of stage that Canelo has long been used to. Berlanga will need to give himself the best chance while on this stage and for potentially returning to it again. He's a legend. He's been in there with the best, so we have to minimize our mistakes, Berlanga said. Legends make mistakes too. He can't slip up either. I'm dangerous, just like he's dangerous. I'm dangerous too. But with us, we are minimizing a lot of mistakes that could happen September 14th, where he could try to execute on it. And we have to limit those open doors and keep them shut. At the end of the day, he's been in there with the best, you know. Now, that is Edgar Berlanga talking ahead of his fight with Saul Canelo Alvarez. You think he's talking a lot of right things, talking of minimizing the mistakes, the openings that Canelo can go through to utilize. He's right. But you see, the problem is you only do one simple mistake in that squared circle, and it's lights out. It's like John DeWelder used to say that it's only a second, or not even a second, microsecond, and you can't dominate him, you can't outbox him, but it takes just one microsecond, and it's lights out. John DeWelder used to say that you need to be at even beyond 100% concentration and no making mistakes at all. You have to be perfect, excellently perfect for you not to be knocked out. That was Deion Wilder before he got caught by Tyson Fury in that second fight and third fight. And before the Joseph Parker, the Zidane Zhang fights, He was beaming with confidence. But it's like that against guys like Canelo. He has that knockout power. He's not that one punch knockout guy, but he piles up the punishment and eventually knocks you out. So you need to be perfectly excellent. You need to be a kind of Floyd when he fought Canelo. You have to be a kind of Dimitri Bivol. All be a triple G, a guy that will consume all that Canelo brings, but also do hand him back what he brings all even better. So you get, and this will be the daunting task for Edgar Berlanga come fight night. He says the jab will be the breadwinner, but it's not only the jab. Dimitri Bivol had the jab, but he kept on flowing volumes of punches, didn't let Canelo have any space of counter punching and do all that thinking of how to counter Bivol's attacks. Bivol was like a swarm of bees coming at you and not letting you go at any one time. Will Berlanga be that kind of guy? Won't he get excited? We've seen him get excited in certain fights and him being knocked down at times. He's cocky, and you don't come in the ring with that kind of cockiness with Canelo, and you don't think you will be you won't be knocked out. So he needs to be quite careful and execute an excellent game plan to overcome the Canelo challenge. Canelo has never been knocked out or knocked down. So for any guy to come in there and do the damage for the 12 rounds or less, you have to be quite a genius at what you're doing. That's what Dimitri Bivol did. That's what Floyd did. And these are all great fighters. So Berlanga needs to show us something that he has never shown us before in this Canelo fight for him to get the win. And we'll be waiting to see. It's just a couple of days before we see this fight, and we will know whether the plan they're talking about will work. But lastly, in his last statements, he was talking of how singing all the praises for Canelo and how he's a legend, how he's been in there with the best guys, and probably putting a disclaimer that, you see, if I lose, this guy is great, this guy is good. I'm just here for the night to put up a performance, and I'm not probably not to lose in a disgraceful manner. But eventually Canelo will win. That's the kind of feeling that I got from his talk about Canelo being great. Place your comment in the comment section below. I sign out. Peace.